Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. In today's video, we continue with the series RAG, Retrieval Augmented Generation, and today we are going to see how to integrate the LangChain Pandas Data Frame Agent with Gemini. Well, let's start. As usual, I have prepared an output that later on I will push to the repository, and I will write a note into the description of this video to later on you be able to download the notebook and replicate what you are going to see on the video in your local environment. So what we are going to see here is a LangChain provide an agent executor, and an agent is a component in LangChain which allow us to essentially integrate or do some tags, no, with a library or with an API or with something if the model or the SDK that you are integrating with allows that, no? And then in this case, what we are gonna do is use an intermediary piece, which is the Pandas Data Frame Agents, which is part of the LangChain experimental library, and this agent essentially what is gonna do is use the capabilities, the function calling capabilities tool of the Gemini SDK or API SDK to execute Python commands which essentially are commands related to the use of the Pandas library. Essentially what we do is invoke a command, a prompt in LangChain. We say to the model what we want to do, and then on the model take this command, this prompt in natural language, and translate this to sentences, to commands in using Pandas. And you are asking the model do some tags with the data frame, extract some information, create a plot, whatever you usually do with a Pandas data frame or with a data frame in using this library. The model, well, more than the model, function calling capabilities in the SDK execute the code that has been produced by the model, and then on the execution of this or the output of this execution is returned back to the model, and with this output is creating the final response that is sending back to the user. So we repeat the process. So you send a command, a prompt to the as input or your chain. In this case, we are creating a chain with this an agent itself, and which is composed two components. One component is the Pandas data frame agent, and the second component is LLM. You will send a command in natural language processes, together with a data frame, the model first of all will analyze the SDK will analyze the data frame, and then once it's analyzed it will create code, Python code in this case, to execute or to do what you introduce as a tag to be executed on the function calling tool. And once this is executed, it will return an output, and this output will be returned back to the LLM, and the LLM will decide if there is necessary to do more actions or return the current output to the user. We are going to see some examples to show you how this works and see how powerful is this capability in LangChain. Today we are integrating with Gemini, but it's also possible to integrate with other technologies let me show you. I will send you later all this information. Executor, well, I don't know where it is now. Exactly, you have here integration of this with exactly here, OpenAI, Anthropic, Google, Fireworks AI, Mistral, and Together AI. These SDKs had this capability, this option of execute code. So tools, there is some the name, how they define the service or the capability on every SDK is different, but essentially what they do is what I described. You send a command, you can define your own tools, create your own tools, and then on you send in the execution chain, you introduce as much as you can define the default tools. You can create your custom, or you can do like we are gonna do here, an integration with a tool which is working with Pandas Data Frames. There is other tools which work with databases, with APIs, but in this case the tool is a tool which is understanding how the library, the Pandas library, works, and then only will create code to interact with the data frame that you attach, and is part of the or is the information, input information of your chain. And then on the models that you see here are they have a native integration with, because all of them provide this functionality on their SDKs, and there is other, some other possibilities to create your custom tools with other models that are not included here. It's much more complicated doing that way, but it's also possible. Again, today we are going to work with Gemini, but the easiest, you can work very easy to translate this code and just work with other agents that integrate directly with, like OpenAI or Anthropic models. So I patch you here all the relevant information, how it's working, the function calling in Google, also all the relevant links to understand how it works this integration. Again, there is many agents. The agents is essentially the component in LangChain which is going to interact with this functionality on the SDKs, or it is not done with the functionalities and SDK. It had their own tools execution engine inside, and they can do with the ones that you develop yourself, no? As a tools that interact with the model. We had already some videos on the channel that explain how to work either with LangChain tools, OpenAI tools, or Gemini tools. Okay, let's move, because this is a specific case of LangChain tools, which is again an integration with the Pandas library. So essentially at the end, what it's going to do is everything that you can do with Pandas is possible to be done here and be used as part of the context or prompt that you send to an LLM to provide information or to create information or data that will help the model to provide you an answer, an appropriate answer to what you are looking for or to what you requested. Okay, in my case, I import the libraries. In the repository, I will upload a part of this install, this OpenPYLXL is to open Excel files, but the rest of the libraries you need to do this, to replicate this in your environment, they are in the requirements TST. This requirement and this notebook I will upload then later on to the repository to you be able to replicate this. So we import this, the libraries we need. I'm using Vertex AI and the Gemini API SDK to access to the models, and also I access to the model using my credentials in Vertex AI, and then on I make as well calls to the SDK API, or more than I make calls, is the land chain who is making this call. So you had to have this in your environmental variables before proceed or before run the change. So I open a Excel file which contain multiple sheets. When you use Pandas React Excel, you can choose which sheets you want to open. In this case, I open the first and the position 0, position 1 of the Excel. This is the sheet 0 of the sheet 1. So you open it with that. Either you can iterate and try to open all the sheets. Either if you know the names, you can use the names. It's not you have to use numbers. And then on it will produce if you do it like this with a list of numbers or a list of names, the names of the sheets, it will produce a dictionary of data frames where the key is the name of the sheet, and can be a number or it can be a name if you know the name. And then on you can access to the individual data frames using just the key as I'm doing here. Then on I create my model with my credentials using the integration GenAI land chain, Google GenAI. This is the integration with the land chain with the Gemini API. And then on here we are gonna do the first step. Just I pass an instruction. I want to understand to extract all the data that belongs to one of the companies that we have here. No, I don't tell her. I don't get any explanation about the structure of the or the schema of this data frame. I just simply in natural language I explain what I want to do, and then just I give the instruction. You need to start the information from company, and you will return all the information you had in the table about that company, and you should present the information in form of CSV with the headers and separated by semicolon. So this is just instruction. You create the agent with your LLM, your data frame, verbose. It's just to show all the execution on the screen, on the notebook in this case. The type, 0-0 React description. This is the default type. Let me show you agents. Exactly. Here you have the type of agents. There is some of them that are specialized for OpenAI, but well, usually if you choose this, you probably well, you will not have any compatibility problem. You can use this as well with OpenAI. If you have you are you want to work with OpenAI, you can define the OpenAI functions or multi-functions template. But well, if you use this one, you are not gonna have any issue with any of them. So you can check the details of all of them. You can see this type of agent is doing a kind of the reactioning every time that execute the code or create the code, is doing an iterative process executing code until it gets the solution. Sometimes, as you will see, it's doing a kind of mistake. It's checking if there is an exception when executing the code, and if there is an exception, it captures the logs, and react accordingly to solve the problem. Okay, so here return the intermediary steps. This means that everything that the chain has been done to get the output is returned back to the user. Then on, you can parse all the intermediary steps to understand what's the change has been done. And here, parsing errors through and allows dangerous codes. This is one of the new parameters just to understand that you are executing code on the backend, in this case, on the backend of Gemini. And it can be kind of the security over becoming or doing something that is not allowed by your security policy in your company. But yeah. This has to be set up, if not, it's gonna fail. So I pass the name of the company and then on, let's execute this. And essentially, you will see. What it's doing. Okay, so you can see here already. Is executing Python. You can see here how it's sliding the data frame, then on convert it to CSV, separate and blah blah blah. And then on here you have the output. Here I just create a method to take or to retrieve the intermediary steps case that you need, and then on the results nor is not more than a dictionary with your input, the output, and the intermediary step. If you take the output, and then on it's just a simply a string, and you can transform this string as you can see here in a pandas data frame. Something wrong here. Sometimes it's not working correct. But yeah, let me just execute it again. And here, as you can see as well, the if you use the function extract input output, you can simply can follow up the intermediary steps. Come on. Well, don't know what happened here now. Probably I need to restart the code. Well, later you can later on execute in your local environment, and I don't know what is going on now here, but yeah, in any case, if you look here, the output is probably because it's some problem here on the format of the in the format that they are how to say returning the model, but I can't guarantee you that before it was working very without any problem. Let me show you the intermediary steps. Here you will say intermediary steps just to you see. Oops. And then on the intermediary steps is just a list of all the there is just here. One, let me say shape. Oops, it's a tuple. Let's check the zero. Here you have the first thing that he did. Then on the one, here is the output. You can retrieve this is exactly what you have here on the logs of the execution in the log execution logs. Okay, let's do another example. Now I want to visualize the status. So as you can see here, the status had this cell that is not needed. It's just telling us that there is the the type of text, the type of data that we had in the column, but we shouldn't consider to plot the histogram. And then when I want to visualize the distribution of the status in this data frame and exclude the number 1. And then you can check here what it's doing. And you can see here the active prior dormant. So the executions, yeah, how many you have. So we had active, what are you, 4 exactly, prior 4 and dormant 2. Again, you can get as well what the model has been done, what has been executed. So you have it here. And then on later parsing the output, you can as well retrieve the code and integrate it in the, in the or in another upstream application to just show what you are seeing here on the logs. Now we are going to work with the famous Titanic dataset. You just open it. And then we are going to create another executor, the 4 values. Here again, we pass the LLN, the data frame, same type, verbose, intermediate streets, and allow dangerous code. And then we just ask the model how many survivors above 50 years in the dataset. Pretty simple. It's just you can see here how it's executed. It's slicing the dataset, survive it, and age equal 50. Notice that I'm not telling which columns contains the age. It's just interpreting the model. My sentence in natural language is interpreting and applying this to the right columns in the data frame. Now here we can base the statistics of the numerical columns, something similar. And yeah, here you have here the numerical columns, apply, describe, and you have the return. Now distribution of p-class, a histogram, and here you can see the output of before. You can see here relationships between P-class and survive. It's just plotting a bar plot here to show the distribution of the standard deviation. Here I'm gonna do hypothesis testing. My hypothesis is there is a significant difference in the ratio of survival if you are a woman below 50 years. Null hypothesis, the ratio of survival being woman, it is not related to being under 50. Or H1, the ratio survival being woman, it is significant relevant if age under 50. So we made the t-test and we need to check the p-value. It is below or above 0.05. The 4 values is what is going to be using. And you can see here as well is okay, yeah, the p-value is greater than 0.05, so so we fail to reject the null hypothesis, differential is right of woman under 50, under 50 and woman of 50 on the Titanic. So there is no statistic reference. So it's exactly, the p-value is greater than 0.05. Applying the t-test to this, you can see here exactly what the model has been done. What has been executed on the in the background, and with the outputs, all these outputs, here we are not. If I don't remember wrong, here we don't. Exactly. So these intermediary steps are returned back to the agent, and this is used as a context as well to the model to answer you for the final answer. And here we just plot the correlations in between the three attributes of our data frame. It's going to slide the data frame. And you can see here the heat map, the correlation, and the heat map using seaborn. And the correlation in between the three of the classes. I think that is pretty powerful. This agent, this integration with pandas, and together with the model. Again, the model can be any of the ones that had native integration. We have six available, and there is also doing custom tools, the possibility to do it with other generative model, not commercial, like Llama 3, for example. But in any case, this integration, this tool, this agent tool, sorry, is really, really interesting, really powerful. And then this will allow us to do many, many things, like data exploratory analysis. It can be done for us. We can just query your data frame using an LLM and show all the outcomes in the screen without the need to practically write a code or write by pandas code. For many, probably this is not very relevant, but believe me, that something very powerful that will allow us to do very interesting things. And also for people who have not a lot of expertise in doing or encoding in some language, it will allow to do some of the stuff for what today you need an specialist, a data analyst or a data scientist to do these kind of activities. Now with the use of the agents tools and LLMs, you can do this even if you don't know how to code any single line of the Python or another language that we usually use on data science. And that's pretty much all. Thank you very much for watching the video up to this point. I hope that you find it interesting, useful, and for your job, for your training, for whatever reason are you watching this video. And if so, just give me a like, subscribe to the channel if you didn't do it before, and share with your colleagues and friends, and make comments, all this stuff to help me to grow on YouTube. Thank you very much, and see you soon.